Amen. Let's pray. Father God, we just want to thank you, Lord, for this morning. And Lord, we ask, Father God, that even today, God, that indeed, Lord, that you just anoint our minds, anoint our hearts, and God, that you'll just help us, Lord. Father God, we pray, God, the Holy Spirit, that you will, God, that indeed, Lord, help us, Lord, you know, bring change in our life, Lord. We need to change, Lord. We need to transform, Lord. We need to see our minds transform. We need to see, Lord, our actions, Lord, our hearts. And even this morning, Lord, we just pray, God, that you'll speak in our hearts. And Lord, we just pray, God, you bless, Lord, even your word. We thank you in Jesus' name. And the people of God said, Amen. And so, what's our theme for this year? Okay, come on, I can't hear you guys. You guys talk so softly. What is the theme for this year? Okay, what's the scripture? John 13, 34 and 35. Come on, say this with me. A new commandment I give to you, that you love one another, even as I've loved you. By this, all men will know that you are my disciples. If you have love, you also love for one another. And so, as I said, right, this was on Thursday night. You know, Friday, right, Jesus is going to the cross to die for us. And the ultimate demonstration of love and service. And then, right, you know, on Thursday night, he's saying this. And before this, right, he had already washed the feet of his disciples. You know, another great act, right, that God, you know, that Jesus would wash the feet of disciples. And then he says this, right, a new commandment I give to you, that you love one another. Amen. And so, right, you know, it's a command that we need to, and that means, right, you know, in everything that we do in Christian life. Amen. That means, right, in everything that when you come on a Sunday morning, we are here to love one another. Amen. That means, right, you know, we are in family, right, we are here to love one another. Amen. Our relationships that we journey, Lord, we're here to love one another. And that loving always involves, right, looking into the well-being of somebody else without really expecting anything in return. Amen. And so, right, that's the kind of agape love that Jesus is looking for in our life. And so, right, you know, this thing, right, you know, I want you guys, you know, if I asked you, right, do you want to see supernatural intervention in your life? Wow, about 20%. Wow. Come on. Do you want to see supernatural intervention? Come on, do you want to see divine favor? How does supernatural intervention, do you want to see new beginnings? Or do you want to see old beginnings? No, new beginnings. We want to see new beginnings. And if you want to see this, right, we need to align ourselves, right, with what God wants us to do. We need to align ourselves, right, with the greatest commandment, you know, to love God with all our hearts. We need to align ourselves with the great commission. But Pastor, it's so simple. Yes, it's so simple. That's why, right, we are not doing what God wants us to do. We are doing everything else, right? And, you know, we are so preoccupied, Lord, with ourselves, right, our challenges and all these things. And yet, right, you know, we are not expressing that love, amen, to each other. We are not expressing to the love, this love, Lord, to the community that we live in. And so we need to take a check in our life and we need to deal. Amen. I want to also say this, right, you know, change comes in our life as we allow, right, God to bring change to the word, right? And so I want you guys to meditate upon John 13, 34, and 35. I want you guys, right, to memorize this, right? I want you guys to read this. Amen. Stick it, right? Get a great image, right, on your phone, right? And use that scripture, right? And put it there, right? Maybe, right, write it on your glasses, right? So you can see every day, right? Amen. Amen. You know, put it right in your heart, right? You know, pray it, right? You know, every time, right, that we meet, pray this over us. Amen. And then, right, you know, obey this, right? Look out for opportunities to serve. Get up in the morning, right, and say, God, what is your assignment for me today, right? What, God, what do you want me to do? Is there a life that needs to be touched? Amen. And, you know, so I want to really challenge you next week, right? You know, I'm really looking forward to next week, right? Because right, that's at the end of the series that we are doing, Live to Love. Amen. But next week, we're going to see, right, the ultimate expression of love at the cross. And I tell you, right, you know, I tell you guys, you know, just be here next week. Why? Because when you talk about Jesus and the cross, right, and when you talk about the love of Jesus at Calvary, you know, God will do some wonderful things in our midst. And, you know, and I'm so excited about next week. Amen. But this morning, we're going to look at a portion of scripture. Amen. You know, you see, yeah, last week we looked at, you know, John 13, and that was, right, before that, Jesus was washing the feet of the disciples. This was a miracle that took place, amen, a bit earlier, right, at the onset of his ministry, in the book of Mark, chapter 1, verses 40 to 42. Amen, Jesus had already, right, you know, been preaching, he'd been going around preaching, you know, Jesus had been healing people, amen, Jesus had done, you know, a lot of deliverance, he was casting out demons. At this point, you also had healed Peter's mother-in-law. Amen. So that there were great things that were happening. And then, right, we come to Mark chapter 1, verses 40 to 42, right? Amen. You know, it's just an amazing portion of Scripture. Amen. Amazing statement that God makes in this Scripture on how, amen, this morning, right, we live to love. Amen. That means, right, you know, how, right, do we journey, right? Amen. You know, how do we journey this whole thing about living to love? Amen. You know, how do we journey, right, you know, to do this, right? Amen. You know, and it must not just be, you know, something that we do, right, you know, when we feel like doing. Come on, there's a choice that all of us have to make, right? A choice about, you know, sometimes that we just do because we feel like doing. Come on, if you and I are going to do things because we feel like doing, we're not going to do it. Amen. You see, right, there's a tension within us. There's a struggle, there's a challenge within us. Amen. A challenge, right? Amen. That whether, right, we should, you know, be selfless or whether we should be selfish. Amen. That whether, right, we want to honor God, amen, and do what God wants us to do, or we are just so self-centered, right, that it's just me, 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 gimme, gimme, my name is Jimmy, gimme, gimme, me, me. Amen. We live the whole life, right, you know, thinking just about ourselves, and we forget, right, there are people next to us. Amen. There are people, right, that, you know, God has put into our lives, right, to love and to care. That, you know, we need to deal, right? We need to, there are choices that we've got to make, right? Whether, right, we are just going to walk in our feeling or whether we're going to be intentional in loving. Hello? Amen. When a boy meets a girl interested, right, he is intentional. He wants to get the girl. Amen. And so that, right, he does whatever it takes, right? But after some years of marriage, they become less intentional. Okay. Okay, but you see, you know, we got to be intentional in loving. Amen. We got to be, you know, the Bible says love one another. Amen. And there is no, come on, in church, right, there is no, like, selective loving. We love the people that we like to love, right? You know, people that we don't like to love, that's not what love is, right? We love whoever, right? We love, right? You know, whichever race, right? Whichever background, right? You know, whoever, right? You know, the Bible says, come on, amen. God calls you to love. Amen. Each one of us, right? When you get to your place of work, God placed you in your place of work. Why? Because you got to, come on, say it to me, live to love. Why did God create you? God created you so that you may, come on, respond to me, please. Amen. God created you so that you may, amen. God saved you. Amen. He died on the cross for you. Greatest demonstration of love so that you may. God gave you gifts. But Pastor, what? All of us have gifts. We are gifts to serve. So that you may use it to, amen. You see, right, everything in life revolves around this. Amen. You know, and you are existing right now, right? Why are you existing? Why are we existing right now? So that, you know, as a result of this, we can be a testimony by living to love, right? Amen. And so this morning, right, you know, I want to, you know, we're just going to look at this portion of Scripture. And, you know, and it's just an amazing portion. Amen. You know, some of you who have been here for many years, I've preached, I think, 2 or 3 times in this Scripture. But, you know, this morning, right, we're just going to look and we're going to just see, right, you know, the Bible says, right, what does the Bible say? The Bible says this. Now, a leper came to him, imploring him, kneeling down to him, and saying to him, if you are willing, you can make me clean. And so what is this, right? You see, right, a need was presented. Come on, say this with me. A need was presented. It's a need that was presented. Amen. You see, right, love operates on meeting needs. And then in verse 42, we're going to look at verse 42. What does the Bible say? As soon as Jesus had spoken, immediately the leprosy left him and he was cleansed. Amen. And so, right, in verse 40, a need was presented. But in verse 42, right, the power was manifested. Amen. There was a need and there was the power manifested to meet the need. Amen. And you and I, right, you know, there are needs. We've got needs, right? Amen. We come across people that have got needs. You know, this week, right? This week, I had to spend some time with a person, right? And I just do not know how. But, you know, got scammed for 500,000 ringgit. You know, I just want to make a public service announcement. Amen. You know, and just say this, right? When somebody calls you up and says, right, you got a court case, or, you know, somebody calls you up, you got a fine to pay, or somebody says they're from Bukit Aman, please, right, don't respond to them, right? Amen. These guys are amazing, right? You know, they've got amazing, you know, wicked skills, right? Amen. To trap people, amen, through language, and trap people, right, through fear. And, you know, and this person, Lord, 500,000, you know, just, right, mortgage stuff, this, right, you know, just caught in this. Amen. And, you know, and then, right, now we are just seeing how to help this person through. I mean, it's already a case in Bukit Aman. And, you know, and they see need to how to recover, right? And so, you know, we need to pray and just help. Because there are people in need. Amen. Come on, the needs are just not sicknesses that you and I battle. Amen. Their needs are not just, right? Amen. You know, family problem. Come on, there's a lot of people struggling. They can come to your plate, okay? They can come to work, right? Smiling at each other, right? But you do not know, right, at home, there's fireworks going on. And bad fireworks. Amen. And so, right, there's needs. Amen. And you see, right, here, right, a need is presented. And the other side, right, the power was manifested. And then, right, you have this powerful scripture. Come on, slap somebody in the back. Powerful scripture. Hello. You guys are not excited. Come on, slap somebody in the back and say, wonderful scripture, right? Verse 41. Mark chapter 1, verse 41. And just look at how Jesus operates. Amazing. The master, you know, some of us, right, all of us at some point, we've been to, you know, how to, you know, improve your communication skills. Let me tell you how to improve your communication skills. The Bible. Amen. You can go for, you know, please, you know, enhance yourself, enrich yourself, right? You know, pay as much money as you want, right? You know, 1,000 ringgit for, you know, all these seminars I do, you know. But, right, listen, amen, the master communicator, right? The master helper, the master servant is Jesus himself. And come on here, right? You look at this portion of scripture. Come on, someone say amazing, awesome, radical loving. And that's what we see here, right? You see, right, how the need was presented. And then, right, the power was manifested. And in between, right, you see what Jesus does. What does Jesus do? The Bible says, then, hello, help me, then. Then, come on, our whole life is Jesus, 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 Jesus. Then Jesus moved with compassion, stretched out his hands and touched him and said to him, I am willing, be cleansed. And that's the end of this message. You know, okay, you know it's here, right? You know, Jesus moved with compassion, stretched out his hand and touched him and said to him, I'm willing, be cleansed, right? Come on, church, this morning, right? You see, right, you know, Jesus was there, leper came. And, you know, for us, right, to live to love, and our job, our assignment, amen, our command from God is to live to love. And for us to do that, amen, you know, here, right, we've got to have a listening ear. Come on, shout out listening ear. We've got to hear, right, the cry of the needy, right? Of course, right, the cry of the needy, hear the leper. Come on, you look at the leper, go back, you know, go back, do your Google, go and ask Mr. Google, right, and you can, you know, you can look at all the scriptures, definition of leprosy, one of the most hideous and horrible sicknesses to experience. Amen. Physical suffering. Amen. Hands, hair drops off. Amen. Not all hair drop off is because of leprosy. Get this straight. Okay, some of us, right? Okay, please. Some of you looking. Oh. Okay. Not, okay. You know, hair drops off, right? And then, right, you know, nails drop off. Then fingers drop off. Then ears drop off. Nose drops off, and then they just rot and die. Hideous. Amen. And again, right, you see, right, you know, physical suffering, you know, they had, you know, they were ostracized. They were social, like social parias, right? They were just completely cut off. And so they were rejected, so emotionally damaged, socially damaged. And then, right, you know, of course, right, all as a result, they're spiritually damaged. And yet, right, you know, the Bible says, right, the leper came to Jesus. You know, I was just preparing this, right? You know, are we approachable? As people see us, right, would they come and say, you know, Suresh, can you help me? You know, are we approachable? And look at Jesus, right? Man, you know, maybe, yes, you know, they knew that he was somebody special, right? But you see, right, you know, Jesus had a listening ear. You know, some of us, right, when we talk, right, we just talk right from, you know, have a conversation, 5 minutes we are talking, and then we don't give the other person any chance to talk, right? And then we say, wow, what a great conversation. Come on. You know, Jesus, we need to have a listening ear. We need to have a seeing eye. Come on. You and I, right, live in this world, right? and we just go on and go on and go on and go on and go on. And there are people out there, if they were to die today, they would go to a Christless eternity. Come on, do we believe in a heaven and a hell? Wow, no response. Do we believe in a heaven and hell? Amen. That means, right, people whose names are not written in the book of life will be cast into the lake of fire. Jesus said, I am the way, I am the truth, I am the life. And who is the vehicle to bring forth this message? It's us. Come on, it's you and it's me. That means, right, everywhere we do, right, when you come in, right, you know, when you see that security guard downstairs, you know, these guys, right, must know that we have a real relationship. When you, after service, right, where are you guys going to do your lunch? Some of you going home. You know, some of you probably go to dim sum. You know, come on. You know, this is our, you know, community that we need to reach out to. Amen. You've got to have a listening ear. Some of you will go to main place, to Nando's. You know, this is our community. Amen. You know, and you and I, we want to live to love, right? We got to have the mindset and the lifestyle of Jesus. Jesus was radical in his loving. Amen. Come on. Everything that Jesus did, right, was against the norms of the Jewish culture at that point of time, as you will see later on. And we need to do, right? Come on. There are things that we need to do as long as God gives us breath. As long, right, as you and I, right, have breath and life in our heart, right, we need to do, right? Amen. And we need to go down to our grave, right, you know, serving the Lord and dying for the cause of Jesus Christ. Can I hear an amen? Amen. And so, right, a listening ear. Come on, he was listening, right? Amen. Jesus, a seeing eye. You and I, right, we can go into situations and we are just, you know, we just can't see some of the needs around, right? Why? Because we are always focusing on ourselves. Amen. We need to deal, right? Why? Because love, right? Love is, you know, love is something, right? It is expressed to somebody else. Amen. Love, right, is there to meet. When I tell my wife I love you, that means, right, I'm here to see, right, how I can help her and meet her need. And you know, if she tells she loves me, right, and that's the way she wants to see how she can meet my need. Amen. And so, right, you know, we've got to see, right, a listening ear, a seeing eye. Come on, we got to see people, right, not with our judgmental, critical mind. Selective. And after this, go down, right, select. Come on, we cannot be selective, right? Because there are people, all of us have got needs. Come on, how many of you do not have needs? Anyone here? The only people that do not have needs are in Nilai Memorial Park. Come on, all of us have needs, right? And all of us, right, you know, the needs now may be slightly different, right, now helping a lady that has been scammed. Amen. You know, and helping, you know, these are things, right? Amen. You know, there are different kinds of needs, right? You know, maybe, right, an act of kindness, something that you do, right? But you and I, right, must understand, right, we've got to have a listening ear and a seeing eye. You see, right, you know, what made, right, this leper come to Jesus? You know, those days, right, you know, they're supposed to keep 6 feet away, like, you know, they can't come across next to the person. And then, right, you know, a leper, when he comes, right, you know, when he meets people, unclean, 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 unclean. Why? Public proclamation. Because his disease is contagious. You know, what kind of damage he would have done, right, you know, to this leper, completely devastated, right? Horrible. Amen. You know, tough life, right? You know, you think life is tough, man, you know, think of this leper, right? Tough, 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 right? Amen. But yet, right, you know, what is Jesus? Jesus listens and Jesus sees. What made, you know, I can just imagine this, right? You know, was Jesus friendly, approachable? Yes, he was, right? Man, if he was not, right, I don't think this leper would have thought, well, you know, Jesus, right, wow. But Jesus, no, Jesus was, he was friendly and approachable and anybody could come to him, right? You know, in the book of Mark, right, you see a lot of other instances how he reached out. Even the kids to come to. Kid, nobody, right? No selective, right? Everybody can come to him. And so this whole area, right, of being approachable, a listening ear, a seeing eye, man, someone that was friendly. And, you know, that's what, right, you know, establishes the connection. Hello? That's what establishes the connection. And then the Bible says, right, he moved with compassion. You see, right, you know, a lot of times in scripture, right, you know, the Bible says, right, before Jesus, he was moved with compassion. He felt for people. He was moved with love. Amen. And, you know, as a result of that, right, the expression of that love is, you know, something that it was an action or a need that is met. You know, last week, remember, right, more than the actions that we do, you know, it comes out about who we are, you know, what's in our heart. Amen. More than who we serve, right? It comes out, right, you know, about who I am. Because if you and I, right, this morning know that Jesus is in us, if you and I know that we are children of God, that Jesus Christ died on the cross first, come on, you and I, right, will deal with situations differently. Like we will minister in the love of Jesus. Hallelujah. Amen. And so a heart of compassion. Why is it? No, let me ask you a question. Why is it, right? You know, sometimes, right, we are, you know, we do not see the needs of others, right? Why? Because, you know, the few things, right? Because we've got to deal with our heart. No? Hello? Amen. You know, you've got a problem in your heart. I've got a problem in my heart, right? All of us, right? And, you know, one of the issues is this, right? That we are really, right, not really abiding with Jesus. You know, if you and I abide with Jesus, amen, if you and I, right, really fellowship with Jesus, you know what will happen? We will see like Jesus sees, right? We will speak like Jesus speaks. We will hear like Jesus hears. And we will act like Jesus acts. And that's why, right, you know, I want to really challenge you, right? Amen, you know, live to love. Come on, tell the person next to you, live to love. Live to love, live to love, live to love. You know, tell yourself, right, you know, come on, call your name and say, Suresh, live to love. Don't call my name. You call your name, Suresh, live to love, live to love, live to love. Amen, come on, that's our lifestyle and for us to live to love. Amen, the great commandment, we've got to love God. And you see, right, you know, you and I love God, we will love others. Right? Another thing, right, why is it so many times we struggle with this? You know, why? Because the Bible says move with compassion. We've got to have a heart for compassion. We got to have a heart of compassion when we see the needs around, right? When you see the poor man on the street, when you walk into the restaurant, amen, when you're doing your lunch there, amen, notice that maybe somebody else on another table, right, that maybe just be having a teh tarik because they don't have money to buy the roti canai and all. Hello? Come on, realities of life. And you and I enjoy, right, our meal, but, you know, observe, right, the things around, right? And just tell the person, right, the shopkeeper and say, listen, I'm going to pay for the person's bill as well. So, amen. So, right, when you see a need, right, see how you can meet it, right? And all it takes, right, is just little acts of kindness that will change the world. Amen. You know, one pastor said, right, one pastor of a mega church, he said, right, if we can get every Christian to smile, we will win the world for Jesus. Come on, show me your smile. Hello? Smile. Amen. Why would people want to come to know Jesus, right, if you got papaya face? Or, you know, if you got a smile, right, joyful. When you walk into a place, people may know, wow, here come the Christians. When you walk to the dim sum shop, amen. Wow, here comes the Christians. When you walk to Nando's, right, amen. Oh, here comes the Christians. You know, amen. And so, listen, a heart of compassion, a heart of joy. You know, why is it, right, we don't have a heart of compassion? Another reason is we are so preoccupied with ourselves. So as Daniel said, right, our priorities, right? You got to get it right. You know, we revolve around ourselves, right? You know, it's all about us, right? It's all about what I can get out of this, right? Begin the relationship with what can I get out of this, right? Amen. It's all about, come on, that's not how, you know, Jesus lives, right? Jesus always lived, right? It's always about others. By the way, this is original. Live to love. What's the difference between live to love? Live and what love? Original, not copied from Google or anywhere else. You know, what's the difference between live and love? Hey, come on, talk to me. I change to, what's O? Others. So, man, if you and I want to live to love, right, it's not about I, it's about others, right, all. Amen. When you and I get up in the morning, right, it's not about I, it's about others. When you and I go to work, right, it's not about I, it's about others. When you and I sit on the train, right, in the LRT, right, and there, right, a person comes up, you know, and, you know, holding there, it's not about I sitting down, right, it's about others sitting down. So we get up and let the others sit down. Amen. And so, right, you know, everything in life, right, revolves around this. And it is little acts of kindness that change. Another thing, right, why is it that we are not moved to compassion? Let me say this, right? Because, right, there's a lot of hurting people. Amen. You and I, right, because we have been hurt in the past, right, we really struggle, right, with really relationships. I've heard people tell me, Pastor, don't expect me to serve. I'm hurting. Pastor, don't expect, I can't relate because I'm hurt. Let me ask you a question. Now, response time, right? How many of you, right, this morning, drive regularly? Not once a year you drive. Drive car. All the time. Okay, come on, wave at me. Don't be shy. It's okay to... Okay, how many of you, right, in your driving, right, you've met with at least one accident? But all the same hands went up. Okay, how many of you, right, you know, you've met at least three accidents, right? What? How many of you drive and have not met with an accident? Wow, you never drive regularly, right? You're all... Amen. Let me ask you a question, right? Have you ever heard somebody say, but Pastor, I'm not going to drive anymore because I'm married in an accident? Right? No, you never hear this, right? Pastor, why aren't you driving? Because, Pastor, I'm not going to drive anymore because, right, I've met with an accident, right? And yet, right, you know, they meet in an accident, they do the insurance, they do the police report, they get back. And yet, right, when people talk about relationship, I'm not going to relate anymore because I'm hurt. Come on, it's not, come on, part of life, right? The longer you live, amen, there will always be opportunities for you to hurt. There is injustice. Come on, amen. There is, right, mistreatment. There is, right, expectations that are not met. Amen. There are, right, you know, struggles. There are unfavorable people. No? Come on, talk to me. Amen. Amen. There are, right, unfavorable circumstances. And you see, right, every hurt that comes, you see, right, you know, so many times we are so hurt and so into our own world, right? You know, Pastor, I'm not doing this, right? Pastor, I cannot do this. I'm too busy. Wow. I'm too busy. It's not whether you're busy or not, whether something is important or not. Or some, hey, this is just joking. Amen. Pastor, I'll pray about this. Amen. Come on, yes, you can pray about this, right? But we are all here to serve, right? There's a need. Amen. If all of us share the need, right, you know, there will be greater, you know, we can do greater things. And so, right, this whole area of hurting, people are hurt. By the way, right, if you want to have move with compassion, right, you got to deal with your hurts because hurting people hurt others. Hurting people build defenses, right, and do not want to get involved and relate. And we got to deal with it. And how do you deal with this? You got to forgive, right? You got to pray first. Right? Pray for them, right? The Bible says, bless your enemies, love your enemies. Amen. And so you got to pray for them. Pray, right? God, please do something to them. First prayer. After about 3 weeks, God, do something. Next week, right? God, please bless them. Bless them. God. And then right, after next week, God, bless them. So, right, what are you doing, right? Amen. You are releasing this, right? Come on, listen to me. Praying for somebody else may not change them, but it will change us. Amen. You know, some years ago, right, at the onset of ministry, you know, first few years, fine. Then, right, I was really struggling because of unfavorable people. Okay. And, you know, I was really struggling. And, you know, and I remember that Saturday night, it was in Roshan's room. Amen. I was there, you know, walking up. And I was saying, Lord, what's happening, Lord? What's happening? And the Lord said, son, the famous words, forgive. And I said, okay, yes, boss. And so I took time, forgive. And then, right, you know, immediately after that, you know, attitude changed. You see, right, you know, my circumstance didn't change, but I changed. Amen. And as a result, that God can position you. When you and I change, right, it positions us for other things. And so, come on, you got to pray, you got to forgive. Amen. When you forgive others, right, You see, right, hurting heart is one of the biggest struggles, right, that people have in relating to others. Amen. And, you know, you just, right, you know, we just so into ourselves. And, you know, when you and I begin to forgive, what happens? When you and I begin to forgive, right, we cannot change our past. But you and I can change our future. Amen. Can I hear an amen? And so this morning, right, you know, God wants us to have a heart of compassion. Move with compassion, right? And then the Bible says this, right? And what did Jesus do after that, right? And he stretched out his hands and touched him. Right? What did Jesus do? My wife said I shouldn't be jumping too much on stage. No? You know, look at me. How did Jesus touch him, right? Did Jesus touch them? The word touch there means Jesus touched him. He did the unthinkable to touch the untouchable. Amen. The leper was untouchable. Jesus did the unthinkable to touch the untouchable because nobody touched the leper. It was against the law. Amen. Nobody touched. Amen. There are some things that we need to do in submission to Almighty God. Amen. And you know, when Jesus did that, it was a touch. What, you know, how would the leper have felt? You know, he would have felt, wow! You know, even before I experienced the feeling, right? You know, someone touched me. Maybe nobody has touched him. You know, sitting in his room, right? People slipping the food, you know, through the doors because nobody wanted to touch him. It was contagious. And yet Jesus touched me. Come on, you and I, God, go touch people's life, right? Amen. You know, you and I, right, you know, we need to touch, right? You know, by our words, our touch, right, by our hands. And let me tell you this, this is an amazing touch tool. Please. I mean, of course, right, people always say handphones are bad and all this, right? You know, too much time, but this is an amazing touch tool. And we can use this, right, for God's glory. And we need a touch. You know, that touch, right, brought forth acceptance. That touch brought forth love. You know, that touch, you know, his rejection, right? You know, people, he was rejected. And yet, right, that touch, you know, what did that touch do? That touch brought, amen, that touch brought, right, healing and, you know, an acceptance. And, you know, and he just felt love. And we need to touch, right? You know, you and I need to touch. We need to act. You know, many years ago, some of you probably heard this before. You know, many years ago, right, at our church camp, at that time I was not a pastor. I was sitting down in front of me on the row before that, there was a guy that was sneezing. And then, right, you know, I was sitting in the next row with my wife. It was our church camp. And then he shouted out, I need a tissue. I need a tissue. And, when somebody shouts, I need a tissue, what do you do? But nobody responded. No. Everybody listening. And the guy said, I need a tissue. And so, right, I quickly called, that's what, darling, he needs a tissue. He needs a tissue. Because ladies have got all kinds of things in their bags. And so, right, you know, took the tissue and just the tissue. And the other things I didn't take. But took the tissue and gave it, right, to this guy, right? And then he was using tissue and wiping his nose. A year later, right, I had to minister to this guy. He was in a terrible situation. He needed to be confronted on something. So I walked into his office. As I walked into his office, he said hi. He already knew that I was coming there. And sometimes, come on, church, if there are issues, we need to speak the truth and help people out of this issue. And so I sat down there. And then I said to him, I think you know why I'm here. He said, yes, I think that time I was Brother Suresh. Yes, Brother Suresh, I know why you're here. And then he said this to me. He said this, right? The only reason, Suresh, that I'm listening to you, because at the church camp, I asked for a tissue, and you were the only one responded. And so, right, you know, I had a chance, right, to deal with that serious problem that he was going through, right? You know, I had to meet a few people that were involved in it as well. But you see, that little act of just giving a tissue opened a door in his heart for me to minister, right? And you got to touch people. Amen. You know, it may be a little act of kindness. Or it may be, right, you know, come on, clean this street, right? Right. People are wondering, all the shops wondering, how come our street not got no entry sign? By the way, when you come in, there's no entry sign this way now. Huh? And people are wondering, there is change that is taking place. Why? Because we got to do these acts of kindness. And then the last thing, right? In this scripture, what did Jesus do, right? And Jesus said to him, I'm willing, be cleansed. Listening ear, a compassionate heart, a loving touch, and then, right, healing words. Amen. You know, when you and I open our mouth, right, what comes out of it, right? Amen. You see, right, you know, we got to, you know, speak words of healing, right? You know, the Bible says, right, you know, I am willing, be cleansed. Amen. And so speak words of encouragement. Amen. If you got nothing, if you have nothing good to say, don't say it. You know, we speak words. And the most wonderful words that you can speak, listen to me, people of God, the most wonderful words that we can speak are words of prayer over people's life. Amen. The most wonderful words that we can speak are words of sharing the goodness of Jesus to them. The most wonderful words that we could speak over people are words of leading them to the Lord. Amen. And so, right, you know, this whole area of words that we speak, right? And so, you know, if you and I, right, this four things, right, if we want to live to love, we've got to address this. Get the worship team up. Amen. You know, we've got to have a listening ear. What do we have to have? A listening ear. So what are we seeing? What are we listening? We need to ask ourselves, right, do what people consider is loving? And how would people feel? You know, do we treat people well? Amen. The second thing is that we need to have a compassionate heart. How do we feel, right? You want compassion or love, right? We've got to connect and we've got to feel the way Jesus feels, right? And then, right, we've got to have a loving touch. Touch. Look out for opportunities, right? You know, maybe right now there's so many interesting ways you can do, right? Maybe maybe your cheesecake is fantastic. How many of you like cheesecake? How many of you can do good cheesecakes? Hey, you need to pray for more cheesecake makers in the church. Amen. And you may have a gifting, right? Or maybe, right, you got to do something, right? Do it for your neighbor. Do something, right? And when you invite people to your home, just don't invite just all your normal people. Invite some different kind of people there. Amen. Touch. See someone, right? You know, the other day, right, you know, somebody has been WhatsApping me, right? I need to visit somebody in hospital in GH. Really so busy, right? Praise God, one of the leaders, right? One of the leaders did it for me. And we are so maxed here, and then, right, there is, they had to go to Kotabaru, right? But you see, right, you know, that leader went, and of course, I was speaking with President, and you know, they went, and then he spoke to me, right, about the need that was there. Like, amen. Touch, right? We can all help each other and we can share the Lord and then words that you speak. So are you ready?